I'd like to cover the difference between what's called greedy versus lazy matching. And this has to do with what happens when you have a repetition operator. So let's say you have some regular expression, and somewhere in here it's got a repetition operator here. The question is, when the regular expression is matching this pattern, there are a bunch of options available to it. Should it match, just try to match none because zero is a legitimate value for the asterisk operator? Should it try to match a bunch of A's because it can, that's also legal? How does it go about doing that? And the answer is that when you see something like this, the regular expression engine is going to try to be greedy. And what I mean by that is it's going to try to do as much of a match as it possibly can. And only when that doesn't work will it back off and try to match something that's smaller than it initially could. On the other hand, if you want to do the opposite, you can have something in there and it looks about the same, except you add a question mark here and the rest of your regular expression is the same. And this is what's called lazy. And this top one's called greedy because it does as much as it possibly can. This one's called lazy because it does as little as it possibly can. So in other words, this first regular expression is going to start out and say, what's the most number of A's that I can possibly match? Try to do that. Whereas this bottom regular expression right here is going to say, what is the least number of A's that I possibly can match? Try to do that first and only match more A's if I absolutely need to. And so they approach it from very different perspectives, and you can get very different matches and very different captures as a result of those different matches, depending upon what these two operators do. So, as an example, let's say we have something that looks like A star B C, and we are the string that we're matching against is A A B C. This what's going to happen, I'm going to mark here the A star in blue. I'm going to mark the B C in red. And what's going to happen is with this greedy algorithm, it's just going to go and match as many of those A's as it possibly can. And then it's going to try to match the B and C, and it's going to work just perfectly. Now, if we had the lazy matching instead, so let me put that in here in an optional kind of orange-ish right here. And we put the lazy matching in, what would happen is it would try this A, and then it would try to match the B C, and it would fail. So it'd say, oh, well, I need to try something a little bit bigger. So now I'm going to try to match, well, actually, the very first match that it would try is zero, right? Because zero is legitimate. It would try to match B C here, and that would fail. So then it would try one A and match B C here, and that would fail. Then it would try two A's and match B C here and fail. It would try to match three A's and then B C here. And finally, it would try to match the four A's and then find the B C here, and it would say, yep, that works, and it would do it like that. Just like we did here with the greedy one. So this is an example where the greedy does a great job because the way our input string works, and the lazy does a horrible job. It's going to take many more steps to find a match than the greedy allocation is. That's just a feature of this regular expression and this input. I could come up with a different input for this regular expression that would have a lot of trouble matching our input, and the lazy expression would work a lot better. So what I'm trying to just point out here is that you have two options for how you tell the regular expression to match with the repetition operators.